Hey there guys, Sam from Professional Music Technology here, and today we're taking a look at the differences between the classic Shure SM58 and its bigger brother, the Beta 58. So if you're wondering whether it's worth upgrading from one of these to one of these, hopefully this video can help you decide. But we're going to throw a little bit of a curveball into the mix by adding another microphone into the comparison. It's a great option if you're looking for a top quality vocal mic. It's the Beta 87A. So let's take a closer look.
Looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel so uninspired. And when I knew I had to face another day, oh Lord, you made me feel so tired. Before the day I met you, life was so unkind, but you're the key to my peace of mind. You make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman.
So before we get into the technical specs of these microphones, let's just quickly run through the obvious differences in terms of design. Now, Shure mics are renowned for their super tough, high quality construction. They say that after a nuclear apocalypse, the only things that are going to survive will be cockroaches and SM58s. Actually, I think I just made that up, but it's probably true. I mean, down here, I've got my own personal SM58. I've had this for about 20 years, played countless gigs with it. It's been dropped about a million times. You can probably see the dents. It smells pretty bad, but it still works absolutely perfectly. And you get that same kind of bomb-proof build quality across all of the Shure microphone range. In terms of dimensions, both 58s are pretty much identical in size and weight, whereas the Beta 87 is a little bit bigger. It does feel significantly lighter and it's got a slightly thinner handle. So you could say that the 87's got the length, the 58's have got the girth, but they all still feel really well balanced, sturdy and comfortable to hold. The Beta microphones are easily identifiable thanks to the distinctive blue band that runs around their grills. Now at first you might think this is just a cosmetic touch, but actually it does have a use. That band's made from rubber, so it means if you put the microphone down on a surface like a table, the added friction makes it less likely that the mic's going to roll off and hit the floor and get damaged. Plus, the grill on the Beta 58 is made from hardened steel, so it's much tougher than a standard SM58 grill, making it much more difficult to dent if you do drop one. All of these microphones are unidirectional, and although you can use them in the studio, they're primarily designed for live vocals. Both the SM58 and the Beta 58 are dynamic microphones, and the Beta 87A is a condenser, but more about that in a moment. Now, whereas the SM58 has a traditional cardioid polar pickup pattern, both of the Beta mics are super cardioids, meaning they offer a narrower pickup pattern with excellent sound rejection from the back and sides. So they're probably better for isolating your vocals on a busy stage and will be less susceptible to feedback. The two Beta mics also offer extended frequency response ranges. An SM58 has a frequency response of 50 Hz up to 15 kHz, but with the Beta 58, the high-end response goes up to 16 kHz, and the 87A, being a more sensitive condenser mic, responds right up to 20 kHz. Of course, how much you actually benefit from those extended frequency ranges will totally depend on the individual tonal characteristics of your voice. So we would always recommend A/B-ing a few different microphones to see which one suits the tone of your voice the best. One thing you will definitely notice is the difference in output volume between the Beta 58 and the SM58, and that's because the Beta uses a neodymium magnet, which results in greater sensitivity and a louder output. It's actually 4 dB hotter than the standard SM58, and it offers a higher signal-to-noise ratio. So overall, that greater sensitivity and extended frequency range tends to result in a cleaner, more detailed reproduction of your voice. Not only that, the Beta 58 also offers reduced handling noise thanks to its advanced internal pneumatic shock mounting system, which minimises vibrations. The Beta 87A though is a completely different microphone. As mentioned earlier, it's a condenser mic. It is the most expensive, but it's also easily the most detailed sounding mic of the three, with its super smooth frequency response and wide dynamic range, a really high quality vocal mic. But being a condenser also has its disadvantages. It's going to be a little bit more fragile than one of the dynamic 58s, so I definitely wouldn't go dropping this or, you know, swinging it around Roger Daltrey style. And that increased sensitivity and extended frequency range probably means it's going to be a bit more susceptible to feedback on a louder stage. So it might not be the best choice if you're the singer in a metal band. And don't forget, obviously, condenser mics are going to need 48 volt phantom power. So if you are trying this one out and wondering why it's not working, make sure to flick that little phantom power switch on your desk. So there we go. That was the main differences between the Shure SM58, Beta 58A and Beta 87A. We're going to take a listen to give you an idea of how they sound in a kind of A-B comparison test. And seeing as we're filming in December, we're going to sing you a Christmas song.
It was Christmas Eve, babe, in the drunk tank, an old man said to me, won't see another one. And then he sang a song, the rare old Mountain Dew. I turned my face away and I dreamed about you. Got on the lucky one, came in 18-1. I've got a feeling this year's for me and you. So happy Christmas. I love you, baby. I can see a better time when all our dreams come true.
They got cars, big as bars, they got rivers of gold. But the wind goes right through you, it's no place for the old. When you first took my hand on a cold Christmas Eve, you promised me Broadway was waiting for me. You were handsome,
you're pretty, queen of New York City. When the band finished playing, they held out for more.
Sinatra was swinging, all the drunks they were singing. We kissed on the corner, then danced through the night.
The boys of the NYPD choir still singing, Galway Bay. And the bells are ringing out for Christmas Day. I could have been someone.
Well, so could anyone. You took my dreams from me when I first found you.
I kept them with me, babe. I put them with my own. Can't make it all alone. I built my dreams around you. The boys of the NYPD choir still singing Galway Bay. And the bells are ringing out for Christmas Day. The boys of the NYPD choir still singing Galway Bay. And the bells are ringing out for Christmas Day.
So thanks for watching. That was the Shure SM58, Beta 58A and Beta 87A. Now obviously you might find it a little bit difficult to hear those subtle tone differences from microphone to microphone when watching a YouTube video, especially if you're watching on, you know, a phone or a tablet or something like that. So I definitely recommend getting down to your local PMT store and doing this comparison test for yourself if you are looking for a new microphone. But for me personally, I'd definitely say for my tone of voice, upgrading from an SM58 to a Beta 58 makes total sense. I mean, I'll take anything that makes me sound like a better singer. So, Santa Claus, I think I've been a good boy. Any chance you can replace my old SM58? So, for more information on all of our Shure microphones, visit pmtonline.co.uk. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/pmthouseofrock. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.